Good morning, students. Today we are going to talk about the poem Vocation. So already we have done it, Vivichan on Vocation. As Vocation, this poem is written by Rabindranath Tagore. So what does the word vocation means? That you have the strong feeling about any career and you love that career, love that profession. So that is the vocation. Suppose I say that as a vocation, he is a poet. So as a vocation, he took that as a poetry. So means that he loves poetry and that's why he is interested. Side by side, he is doing the poet as poems also, composing the poems. So that is as a vocation means you have the strong desire for that strong feeling of a suitability of a particular career. So that is suitable to you and you love it. So the thing which you love it, you will do it with great devotion and dedication, and that will be the best. You will give it to others. So this is the vocation. Now listen here. Here we are talking about the children. Children, he has only one work, that is they have to study. So that to have study and the elders are free, elders don't study. This feeling is there in their mind. So they think that elders are happier than us because they don't have to study. So children have the only work, that is to study. But this work also they find it that no, I have to get up and go to school. I have to do the homework. My parents are free. My elders are free. They don't have to go to school. They only remain at home and do the work. So in this way, that mentality is there. And that is the psychology of the children, that elders are happier than me, than the children. So here we are in this poem also, we are talking about the same feelings of the children, that is a child. So what does the child thinks of the elders and about all other professions which the elders are doing? He thinks, no, it is better than my. I have to go to school and study hard. I have to do the homework. And sometimes scolding is by my parents, by my teacher. So I have to hear a lot from others. So it is better to be elder and do only our work. So that is there in this poem. It is revealed. So we will talk about the poem. When the gong sounds 10 in the morning and I walk to school by our lane. So when there is a gong in the clock, there is a 10 in the morning. I have to go to school and through the small lane, I will go there. Every day I meet the hawker crying bangles, crystal bangles. So on the way, he meets the hawker. Hawker means to beach the hai raste pe. He will cry loud. Bangles, crystal bangles. So he thinks that no, he is better than me because he doesn't have to go to school. There is nothing to hurry him on. There is no road he must take. No place he must go to. No time when he must come down. So what does he think now, the child? Ki no, usko koi jaldi nahi hai. He may go anywhere. Particular road he is not taking. I have to go to school daily on the particular time. And no place where he has to go. And no barrier of time also. Whenever he decides, he may go there. I wish I were a hawker, spending my day in the road, crying bangles, crystals, bangles. So I should be also like that hawker. Don't have to go in the right time to school. And I will not hear the scolding of anyone. And I can also shout on the road and go anywhere. Bangles, crystal bangles. For him, only the school is a burden. So he thinks that all other works are easy. Because the child is small. He can't understand the responsibility of the elders and the work which they do. When at 4 in the afternoon, I come back from the school. So he's saying that I have to go to school at 10 o'clock. And I come back at 4 in the evening. And then also while coming back from the school, I can see through the gate. That house, the gardener digging the ground. So through the gates of the houses which he sees on the road, he sees that the gardener is working in the garden. He is digging there something, ground. He does what he likes with his spade. He soils his clothes with dust. Nobody takes him to task. He thinks that whatever he likes, he will do it. And all his clothes are dirty because of the soil there. But no one is there to scold him. And what about the child? If he will make dirty his clothes, then mother will shout, elders will shout. If he gets baked in the sun or gets wet, what will happen? Baked in the sun means if he feels hot or in the sun, he will get baked. And other wet in rainy season also, if it is getting more rain there, what will happen? Nothing will happen. It is, no one is going to scold him, no one is going to talk about it. But if I get such things, then my parents will scold me. I wish I were a gardener digging away at the garden with nobody to stop me from digging. Now what he thinks? No, gardener is more happy than me. So he can soil his clothes. No one is there to scold him. So I wish I should be a gardener and doing my work slowly, slowly, and whatever I do, nobody is going to stop me in digging. Just as it gets dark in the evening and my mother sends me to bed. So what is his routine after coming from school? He has to wash his hands and take a little bit refreshments there. Then after that, he has to do the homework. Then again, dinner. And when mother sends me to bed in the dark in the evening, what he sees through his window? I can see through my open window the watchman walking up and down. So he sees in the night, what is the work of the watchman? Moving to and fro, up and down, he is moving in the building. The lane is dark and lonely, and the street's lamp stands like a giant with one red eye in its head. So the lane, the whole lane is dark and no one is on the lane because it is the night time, everyone has gone to sleep. And the street lamps, only there we can see the street lamp like a giant with vast structure with one red eye in its head. We will see the light on the head of the lantern. So that is there. So here the reference is given there, like a giant with one red eye. Means this, actually the reference is taken from the Greek mythology, that is the Homer's Odyssey. So it has been taken. As we have Mahabharat, Ramayana, so Greek also has their two mythological books. That is, one is, that is Odyssey there. It is written by Homer. So there, that is, it has taken one red eye with its head. So the lamp is compared to that. Now the watchman swings his lantern and walks with his shadow at his side. So in the night, the lantern is there with the watchman, because in those days there were no street lights, no lights at all. So that is, in the hands he took the lantern and moving that, he would see his shadow only and never once goes to bed. He's like, and he thinks that this watchman never goes to bed in the in his life. Now again, so this is, he is more happy because my mother makes me to sleep and scolds me to fall that you should go now to sleep. So everywhere there is a time barrier. But I think, I wish I were a watchman walking the street all night, chasing the shadows with my lantern. So he thinks that the watchman, he has no work to do, only he is moving here and there with the shadows and taking the lantern by his side. And he has nothing to do because he has nothing to get up early in the morning to go to school or anything else. So he thinks that, no, I will be a watchman. If I would be a watchman, then I will be also happy. My mother will not be there to send me to bed and do all the activities early, get up in the morning, do the activities and go to school in this way. So whomever he sees, the elderly persons doing the work, he thinks that they are more happier than me. So this is the poem which is written or penned by Rabindranath Tagore. So that is the school going child, what psychology he has, the child has. Okay, that is mentioned here in the poem. So the children's psychology is that everyone is happy, the adults are so happy as they don't have to sit. Okay, so that is there expressed here. So he thinks that he might be a hawker, he might be a gardener, he might be a watchman. They are more happier than me, they don't have to go to school. No one is there to scold them. No one is there to compel them, force them to go to bed and do the homework and all these things. So if you see the poem, some first there are four lines, then in the next stanza, six lines, then next nine lines. And in this way, it has no proper rhyme scheme is followed and no meter is followed. So Rabindranath Tagore has written this poem in free verse there. No rhyme scheme is followed throughout the poem there. And if you see the examples there, so many times repetition is there, alliteration is there, bangles, crystal bangles. So there we find the repetition of the word. And in the next line here, antithesis is there, watchman walking up and down. So here you will find out antithesis, opposite words, up and down are used in a single sentence. And then in the next line, lamp stands like a giant. So lamp is compared to a giant. So it is simile. So simile, lamp is compared to a giant. So only two, three figures of speech are used and very nice, very simple. poem Rabindranath Tagore has written, and he has written these poems nearly 150 years ago. So at that time there were no street lights, and children used to go on foot to school. They were used to go by walking, and the schools were near only. So all these fellows, they used to see there the hawkers, the gardener, the watchman, and in this way only they have to go to school and do their homework. That was the only thing. So what is the central idea here? So about the school going children, that they think that elders are more happier than them, and every job is easy for them, as they haven't the experience of any other job, only they go to school. So going to school is a big job for children. They can't understand or they can't realize the difficulties of any, because as they are so small, they can't realize. So that is the poem about the psychology of the children. Okay, so we have discussed the figures of speech also in this poem. And here, if you want to write the poem appreciation, so you will, in the first paragraph, you will write down about the name of the poem and who has written the poem. In the second paragraph, about the rhyme scheme, it is a without rhyme scheme. Okay, no meter is followed, so the poem is written in free verse, and many figures of speech, you can write the name of repetition, antithesis, simile. One which stands out is a simile here, you can, because here lamp is compared to a giant one with red eye, so that you can write a simile. And the central idea, that is about the psychology of a school going children who thinks that everyone is happier than him, as he has to go to school and do all the types of homework and hear scoldings from parents as well as from the teachers. Okay, so next day we will revise the next lesson. Till then, goodbye everyone. Have a nice time.